fall finds us in the rugged mountains of southern Colorado, hunting the coveted Rocky Mountain Bighorn with friends Bob Senta, Milo Gerber, Mike Lancaster, and Doyle Moss.
Mike's got it.
Okay, there's a shot.
Let's shoot him again.
Where did I hit him?
In the back, farther back. Aim right at his shoulder.
Nice and smooth, Bob.
Perfect height, so wherever you aimed on your height. Perfect shot, right in the shoulder. What a ram. Look at that.
Look at that.
Bob, what a shot. What a great ram. Man, what a beauty. Mike, why don't you tell us a story on this ram? Started from a little scouting expedition yesterday, and just tell us the fun events we had.
Yeah, it was kind of a rush deal. Doyle and I were down Southern Colorado guiding some elk hunts and had some hunts kind of stacked up. We got our elk hunt done and headed up here and scouted yesterday and spotted a group of 12 rams. This monster was one of the rams. We nicknamed him Chipper because he's got this big chip out of the back of his left horn. Does nothing but give him character. Anyway, we watched him last night until dark and they eased off the backside of this ridge we're sitting on. Pretty vertical country. We watched him until it was too dark to see him anymore and made our plan, and the way we were walking in the morning, met up with Bob. This morning we got a start before light and trudged our way, busted brush the whole way. Everybody looked like they had taken a shower by the time we got to the top of the ridge, and we were thinking, man, where are they? About this time fog sets in, it's very ominous. We're thinking, geez, could this turn out bad? About that time we hear some rams butting heads up the valley, and we're going, uh-oh, we're getting close. We worked our way up this ridge, you can see behind us, set up, and we could see this ram and all his partners right on the ridge line. Sure enough, they had spotted us. We're thinking, oh geez, the game's over. But we relaxed, they relaxed, and we sat there for an hour with the fog moving in and moving out, and this ram's top of his shoulder barely visible over the top of the ridge. We're thinking, which way are they going to go? Are they going to bail away from us, or are they going to come our way? We're thinking and keeping our fingers crossed that they were going to go the right way, huh, Bob? We had gotten ourselves a great spot, a great rest. We were ready. We waited. Unbelievably, one of the rams comes over this side of the hill. We're thinking, can this happen? Can this truly be happening? Sure enough, the big boy followed him. But as it would happen in every story, the little ram's right beside him. Don't shoot, hold on, Bob. Big fog bank moves in. We're thinking, oh man, what's gonna happen? Are we gonna be fogged in for the rest of the day? And then like magic, he came back over the ridge, laid down where we could see him. Up he came, Bob takes a shot. Bob takes a second shot, put him down for good. Where did I hit him?
Aim right at his shoulder.
Nice and smooth, Bob. He's not going
anywhere. Perfect shot, right in the shoulder.
It's history.
I mean, this ram just had too much love for life. Isn't he a beauty? What is that horn? Did we tape that out of it?
I think that one was 42 inches.
Oh, my word.
42 on his left and 38 and 3/4 on his right. He'll shoot that right around 184.
Bob's ram, Chipper, had eluded hunters for years. We aren't sure if the huge chip was caused by fighting with other rams or an overexcited hunter. This ram is the largest known to be harvested in Colorado's 1997 season.